はじめまして、ベカです。どうぞよろしく。今週はスクーバードゥーです。の次のミュージックビデオをプレビューできることを。
こちらはスクーバーとドゥーバーとの自己紹介でございます。
スクーバーとドゥーバーとと言います。それはちょっと難しいですね。はじめまして。僕の本物の名前は秘密です。アメリカのカリフォルニアのサンディエゴ市で生まれ育ちました。今もサンディエゴに住んでいます。ギターを弾いたり、ビールを作り、メレタンを測り、日本語を勉強します。このコーラソングは Nico Touches the Walls の歌です。ホルグラムと言います。2週間で YouTube にあります。少々お待ちください。よろしくお願いします、皆さん。じゃあ、またね。
While I do love Japanese and I did take it in college, I would never say that I know Japanese. Scoobert Dubert, on the other hand, on top of all his other talents,knows Japanese. We will be premiering that music video on the show next week. Totimo yoi. Nope, not gonna translate any of that for you. Spotify is moving on Netflix like a bitch. Ugh. What a gross thing to say. Oh yeah, that's a phrase I know because the President of America said it. About a woman, right? Reminder to watch the first presidential debate tomorrow night and to vote for Joe Biden.Anyway, Spotify announced last week that they are going to start making shows and films related to their podcasts. They have a non-exclusive partnership with Sweden-based Chernin Entertainment. The move away from music streaming is aimed at profitability for the company. Guess what time of year it is? Yep. For your consideration time. And here on the show, we are going to start highlighting work we think deserves a Grammy. So this week, we'll start with Sophia Chang's absolutely must-hear audiobook,The baddest bitch in the room.
I want people to understand that my story is unique and my voice is powerful and that I deserve to be heard and I need to be heard, not just for me, but to crack open the country's imagination on what I can be. Asian, immigrant, woman, over 50, single mother. See me.
I'm currently listening to it on Audible and let me tell you,Sophia has created an unprecedented work, including the author's voice, guest voices, sound design, original score, needle drops, scratches by DJ Scratch, bonus content, and two versions, clean and f***ing explicit. So, if there are any voting members of the Academy watching, and I know there are, right? Give Sophia Chang a Grammy, dammit. I'm sure that'll work. We have a lot of sway here at Blonde Records. And did you know that our entire roster is going to win multiple Grammys in the future?Submissions for the Libero Awards are also open until early December. You have to be a member of A2IM to submit. They have a new artist program that they started this year. Show notes! Additionally, South by Southwest announced they are going virtual in 2021 with tentative in-person plans. Most music slots will give 2020 performers priority, but film submissions include music videos and open on October 6th. Again, show notes for more.I feel like this is a good segue to get into what's up with Kanye this week. Do accolades even matter anymore? And what does Section 203 of the US Copyright Act say again? I'm calling in our entertainment lawyer for this one. What's up, Mike Lawrence?
Hey, Rebecca. So Section 203 of the Copyright Act gives artists the right to terminate copyright transfers. Now, for artists, that copyright transfer will be the signing of a record contract.Artists in that scenario will have 35 years from the time they sign their record contract to terminate that transfer. You need to find out what the effective date is. The effective date for artists who sign record deals is 35 years after the date you sign your record contract. From that point in time, you have 5 years to terminate your copyright transfer. There is a little bit of a wrinkle in that Section 203 does not apply to works made for hire.That is something that you definitely would need legal counsel for to make sure that your records under your record contract are eligible for copyright termination transfers. So those are just some important guidelines and tips to follow. As always, you could consult me at MikeLawrenceLaw.com.
Thanks, Mike. And I kind of want to know what's going on with Kanye's political birthday party and TikTok, too.Sounds like a job for him.
I've got you covered, Rebecca. This week, Kanye's campaign started working with longtime Republican strategist Nathan Sproul. Since there's no clear agenda or events planned, and the main goal seems to be getting on the ballot, it's fair to say that the Republican operative strategy is indeed to siphon votes from Joe Biden by getting on the ballot in as many states as possible. But here's what I want to know. Why would would-be Biden voters vote for Kanye, who's pretty conservative in his politics and increasingly religious? These are two factors Republican voters tend to gravitate towards, not Democrats. Are the Republicans playing themselves again? Now, on to TikTok news. It is assumed that if a ban happens and were to persist for 6 months, 90% of TikTok users would never return. Are you part of that 90%? According to TikTok's interim global head, Vanessa Pappas, TikTok would not be able to recover for lost ground because people will move on to competing apps like Byte, Triller, Zin, and Reels. And now, I'm so happy to tell you about America's Got Talent, Dancing with the Stars, and deaf community activist Niall DeMarco's latest project.
How she play us?
She a psychology major.
Lately, I just wanna try.
I'm from a hearing culture. I don't sign all the time. I talk.
That I'm gonna break the rules and be.
If you like a docuseries, hi Carol Baskin, then join me in watching Deaf You started October 9th. In other news, Noelle Skaggs from the band Fits and the Tantrums has started an initiative called Diversify the Stage, which seeks to create opportunities for people of color, women, transgender, and LGBTQIA people on the stage, especially in production and technical jobs. Now, this is the kind of good news I want to hear. Let's diversify the stage, diversify the music industry, and create opportunities for people who aren't white men.
Thanks, Em. Wow. I can't wait to watch Deaf You. Another newly released bit of air flair you've got to watch is one of our first performers on the show, Z-Sai's new music video for Anti-Gravity.
You're my anti-gravity, you are my anti-gravity. Pull me in directions I cannot see. You have no perception. You need some stability, try some stability. Aren't you ever who you need to be? You have no direction.
We love you, Z. All right, now who is excited for season one of the Rose Ball? We are, because one of our very favorite drag performers is a cast member. We've featured Kitty and Flame Knight Fever on the show before, so you may be familiar with this divine being already. If not, here's an intro.
My name is Kitty Scofflaw, I'm 25 years old. I prefer they, them pronouns. I'm originally from the Hudson Valley, but I now live in Ithaca, New York. Fun, unique, and kitschy. And sort of as I was coming out more publicly as queer, I also was getting braver with experimenting with gender bending, gender fuckery, gender tomfoolery, just the mixing of all the things. And now I am what you see before you today, a fully fledged gender fuck drag king.
And a surprise. Kitschy is here in the studio. Thanks so much for being here, Kitschy Scofflaw.
It's me, I'm here. Thanks for having me, Rebecca.
Now tell us why we should watch this new show.
You should watch The Rose Ball because it's literally performers from all over the world, not even the country, the world. Everyone is stunning. Everyone's an amazing performer. It's a great competition. If you like RuPaul's Drag Race, you're gonna love this. If you like Dragula, you're gonna love this. It's honestly, it's tough competition, but everyone is very, very talented, and I feel honored to be a part of it. Vote for me. I don't know if you can even vote, but, like, vote for me in your hearts, and like all the posts, and it's entertaining. This competition is forcing me to push myself in new directions that I have never gone in before. I'm going bigger, brighter, bolder, more colorful, more pizzazzy. So yeah, tune in. You may have heard of me, Kitschy Scofla, because of Flame Night Fever, which if you watch this show, you've heard about Flame Night Fever. Flame Night Fever is every third Thursday of the month at 8 p.m. on twitch.tv/flamenightfever. It's a drag and burlesque show featuring a lot of performers from Ithaca, New York, but also performers from literally everywhere. It's an awesome show. It's always followed by a dance party, an interactive dance party with a DJ live. It's awesome. It's community. Come with tips. We always love getting new submissions. Just email flamenightfever@gmail.com and show us what you've got.
Thanks, Kitschy. That premiered last Friday, and you can follow along at the link in the show notes. And now, your musical moment of diversion. Here's Sam Sumter with quick picks from your favorite Brooklyn-based music blog, Bands Do BK.
Thanks, Rebecca. Bands Do BK is Guide to Brooklyn by bands for everyone. And we're going to start off with a group that doesn't just make great t-shirts, but great music as well. This is the new video from Ben Stiller for their song, The Poets. Great group. Not to be a tease, but they were the last band I saw back in March and are absolutely incredible live. So whenever that's a thing, be sure and check them out. But in the interim, you can stay tuned for their debut EP, Nihilist, which is coming out on October 9th. Next up, we have the debut record from one of my favorite Brooklyn duos. This is Tallbird's Lost Pet poster template.
I'm pushing, aiming for the sky. So don't push it, don't push it, don't push it.
Tallbird is made up of members of UV Rays, another excellent Brooklyn band worth checking out. That was the title track and one of three songs that premiered on Bands Do BK on the radio this week, which was so, so fun to do. You can check out all of those songs and the rest of the album and buy it, of course, at tallbird.bandcamp.com. And speaking of new releases from dreamy duos, we have Wildflower, one of the newest from Vampire Boy. Vampire Boy is Time Vampire and Lost Boy. The duo released this song along with Trippin' on Honky Tonk Funk Baby just this past week. Both these songs and more will be on their upcoming album, Canal Street, which comes out on Friday. All proceeds from this record go to Equality for Flatbush, and you can pre-order it now at AmericanBuffaloRecordings.bandcamp.com. And because two is clearly the number of the day, though completely accidentally, if we're being honest. Next up, we have Party for Two, the new song and video from Boyfriends Who Sing Together, Fab the Duo. Fab the Duo describe themselves as the modern-day Sonny and Cher, but we're both Cher. I absolutely love that description. You can check out that song and video for Party for Two out everywhere now, as well as their new album, Our Love is Resistance, which just dropped this summer. And fifth, we've got a song that's a lot prettier than the title indicates. This is Fungus, the new single from Glom. Love these guys. Two of them did a lovely little live stream for me for Planned Parenthood this week, and you can check that out on Instagram. Be sure and stay tuned for Glom's upcoming album, Merit, which is coming out soon. And finally, I want to wrap up by giving a huge shout out and big congrats to absolutely beautiful people who put out an absolutely beautiful record this week. Patterns from Scout is out now.
Oh, darling, can't you see that we can do whatever?
It's such a phenomenal piece of work, and I am such a massive fan. So shout out and congrats, Laura and Connor. I love you. This has been Bands to BK, a guide to Brooklyn by bands for everyone, and we will see you next week. Back to you, Rebecca.
Thanks, Sam. Love it, as always. Now, because I also think of the show as a documentary for this time, and I am first and foremost a documentary filmmaker. I know, shocking, right? I feel compelled to document that October is going to be BANANAS. I personally think that the fall of the patriarchy looks like what is happening. Capitalism gave rise to economic inequity. America might well be evolving into B-America. And let's be honest, that was always going to be messy. But it's necessary if humanity is going to consciously evolve. I believe in the power of a consciously evolving humanity, and that our rich culture of music and arts can shape the future we deserve, the future Brianna's legacy deserves. It's time to fight for that with all we've got. Stay safe, stay positive, save the world. I'm Rebecca Sam.